Hello class 5, welcome to your science online classes, and we have already at the end of the chapter food and health, and we have already done that infectious and non-infectious disease, and we were in the last video we were doing the non-infectious diseases, where I have told you that we will start with page 7 of your book and we will discuss the chart. So please open this page 7 of your science book. See here, this chart, you don't have to buy her the entire chart. You just have to read the name of the vitamins, the sources, functions and the deficiency diseases. Mainly the deficiency disease you have to read, because for the objective, okay, from here objective can come. The entire chart will not come for your exam. It is very difficult for you to memorize and keep it in mind. So see, important vitamins, before we go to the complete page 6, we must discuss the deficiency disease. Important vitamins and minerals and their deficiency disease. See, all the types of vitamins are written over here. Vitamin A, source, carrot, milk, liver, butter, green leafy vegetables, sweet potato, yellow fruits and vegetables. Now function, protects eye, helps to keep skin, bone and hair, teeth healthy. Now, deficiency disease of vitamin A, if I ask, you have to tell. Night blindness, cannot see properly in the dark. B1, vitamin B1, milk, fish, beans, meat, whole grains and nuts. Need for proper functioning of nerves and heart. And the deficiency disease is very loss of appetite and tiredness. Tiredness affect nerve and heart. So, if you feel tired, it will affect your heart and nerve obviously. Or maybe due to the illness of heart and nerve, you are feeling tired. That can also occur. Vitamin C, orange and other citrus foods like cauliflower, tomato, capsicum, chili. What are the functions needed for normal growth and development? And scurvy is bleeding of the gum. It's very bad and very much painful. Vitamin D, milk, cheese, fish, eggs, sunlight. So vitamin D is very important. Vitamin D deficiency disease occurs, and due to that we have to, even I am experienced about that. I was having vitamin D deficiency, and that's why vitamin D3 medicine I have to eat, and that have given me some more vitamins which I need. So you should eat all types of foods in your routine. Ensures health, bones and teeth. And weaken means bones become twisted, it leads to bend. Minerals such as iron, calcium, phosphorus and iodine. See, iron, I am telling. What are the source of iron? Liver, meat, seafood, spinach and beans. Function, part of red blood cell. So they used to form red blood cell. And if there is deficiency of iron, we all know it is very common that anemia occurs, which disease of blood, which used to reduce the amount of blood in the body. Body is pale, and as the blood is not inadequate, it looks pale. Calcium, milk, teeth, bone, milk products, egg, green leafy vegetables, strength bones and teeth. We all know this. And finally, soft and weakened bones, bad teeth. So each and every type of, all type of food and their deficiency disease will be for their objective purpose. Phosphorus, what are the source? Meat, fish and meat products, eggs, beans and grains. Strengthen bones and teeth, maintain the body. Pain in the joint, poor bones development. So in the joints, the patient used to feel pain. And finally, iodine, seafood, iodized salt, controls growth and body activity. And finally, goiter. Goiter here in this neckline, this part used to be swollen. Swell. Swell means phule jao. Okay, so that is also a problem. So this is all about the chart today, and next day we will complete in the next video. So as I have told you that all the different types of vitamins and minerals and their deficiency disease you have to keep in mind, and finally what are the example of different foods and nutrients, that also you have to keep in mind for objective especially. Finally, next day we will do the exercises and posture, and we will complete the chapter. Thank you.